Welcome back to my channel. In this session, I will discuss how we can power up any electronic circuit. What are the safety parameters? This video is specially for safety. When we are working on power electronics, first of all, see it carefully, make a visual check. Visual inspection, you can find some discoloration. Any items which are discolored, so you can identify that here may be the problem. This area is heat up, this area is heat up, so that means there is something wrong with this area. When you want to power it up, check the input resistance of any device. For example, this one, set multimeter to ohms. Connect to input terminal. It is 0.722 mega, 700 kilo ohms. Reverse the leads. It is 0.672 mega, that means 672 kilo ohms. That means it is good. Then we can verify the fuse, either fuse is good or no. So fuse is good. What points we must take here? The first thing, we will deal with live electrical circuits. We will apply line and neutral. Use a wooden table, then use neutral rubber sheet so that there should no electric discharge in the table. If you are using wooden table, that wooden table must not have any metallic nails or metallic connections. Your chair must be the plastic chair, lab chair, and you must isolate yourself. For that purpose, you can use a wooden rack, as I am using in my lab. This is wooden rack. It is with height, so that in case of any touching to live circuit, I will not exposed to the electrical shock. Okay, I will receive the electrical voltage in my body, but I will not feel any electrical stroke. Why? Because I am insulated from the ground due to this wooden rack. Our table must be free from all the debris. When we work like this, these small electrical connectors, the solder droplets, that are very dangerous. If you will place this board here, it can make short circuit, or maybe we will just put it here, any conductor will touch to the board, and when we will apply power, it will damage. So we must take here for the cleaning of the table. So the table surface must be free from conducting materials, everything. Then to apply power, we will take a holder, a tungsten lamp. It is 100 watt tungsten lamp. I am using two wire. It is a best practice when we are repairing. During repair, we must remove ground. That is for more safety. We will take neutral wire directly, and the line wire will enter in this holder. It will go to the lamp and it will come out from the lamp. Now one wire will reach directly to the board, and the second wire will enter in this lamp and it will come out from the lamp. Due to any fault, due to any problem, any time, if we have a short circuit in the board, either it is our original fault or our mistake during repair work. So this lamp will protect, it will cover that mistake and it will protect that fault, and it will not cause to make more damages. Now I am connecting the line and the neutral here. You can also connect crocodiles in front of these wires at the end here, so that you can connect to any point as per requirement. If you want to make connections, you can make tinning for these ends as well. I will apply the power. You can see the lamp is illuminating. Why? Even we checked the input resistance, the input resistance was high, but still it is making short circuit. That means this board have problem. And if I will connect directly to the power, if it is consuming more current, it will damage the fuse, it will damage the other components. So it is the best practice, always use series lamp while repairing to protect the circuit from any more damages. Let's see where is the problem. When you are working on the boards, always check DC voltage on this capacitor. This is the first point. Okay, there are no voltage. Now we need to check continuity at the same capacitor. If there are voltage, never check continuity. If there are no voltage, we can see it is giving just only 6 ohm resistance. Check resistance in both directions. So it have something wrong. This diode, it is good. Now I will apply power and we will check the voltage. Never touch any electrical circuit when it is powered on. See the voltage? We have just only 2.6 volts. 2.6 volts are being dropped in the circuit, whole circuit. Other all supply is now dropped across this series lamp. 226 volts are being dropped at this lamp. Why? Because there is short circuit. If we check the voltage across this DC capacitor, it is just only 0.891 volt. So that means there is short circuit. So that is the reason that it is consuming all the power. Check voltage again. For more safety, discharge it. If there are voltage, then discharge with any discharging device, any soldering iron, use two wires of the soldering iron, series lamp, or you can use a resistor, you can use NTC, PTC to discharge it. Now connect black lead to this negative terminal and check to the input terminal. It is giving one diode resistance. When you are connecting black lead to the negative terminal, and here black lead, here red lead at the diode mount, it must not give anything. It is giving diode. Move to the positive terminal, it is also giving diode. That means there is something short circuit. If you see the circuit, line is coming to fuse here, after fuse reaching to the bridge rectifier, and the second wire is coming directly to this filter capacitor, and then we have bridge rectifier. If this circuit is good, this transistor is open, and it must be open. At that time it will not allow any current to flow. When this IC will start switching, at that time it will give pulses and it will cause to flow the current in the transformer winding. But in this case, when we are taking continuity from this negative terminal, let's see it logically. from this point to this point. We have one diode here, we have one diode here. It is open circuit. Why? Diodes are reverse biased. These two diodes. It is giving 0.6 ohm resistance. It is also giving 0.6 ohm resistance. That is not good. From this side and to this side. How we can see where is the fault? So that means the fault, if I am connecting here at this side and I am taking continuity here, that means this diode is reverse bias. Then the second possible reason, that this current is coming from here and it is making forward bias these diodes. That means this IC is bad. I will remove this IC. After removing this IC, we will see what was the benefit of this series lamp. Now this is out. It is here. Now we will check the continuity here, which we were finding here at this capacitor. Now it is open. That means this IC was making problem. So this IC is short circuit internally. It have built-in MOSFET. Now let's apply power and then we will see the benefit of this series lamp. Now I connected power. The lamp is off. Check AC voltage. So it is 228. The lamp is off. See the DC voltage. 328 volt. Perfect. That means our this IC was making short circuit internally and it was dropping the voltage. We can see now it is dropping very slowly. I remove the power. So this series lamp, it will assist us to protect the circuit. Now we will see in the second angle. If we apply power directly, what will happen? At that time, might be it will damage the fuse, might be it will damage the diodes, rectifiers. So IC is already damaged, and if we don't use series lamp, we will add more failure components in the circuit. So it is the best practice to use series lamp in the repair. So physically what we are doing, this is our line neutral. We are adding a series load. Even if we make jumper from here to here, line to neutral, it will not make any blast. It will cause to allow full current flow from the series lamp, so lamp will glow. Either we are making jumper from here or we are making jumper from here. If we see from this point, we are connecting just two diodes in line to neutral. These are our line voltage. If one diode is connected here, this is now short circuit and it is completing its path to the line. If you connect supply without lamp, it will damage these diodes, fuse. Let's connect it another time and then we will see. Now I connected this IC again and I will apply power. Yes, now the lamp is turned on again. Now the lamp is illuminating full. That means our problem is this IC. So in this way we can troubleshoot the circuit without damaging to the circuit. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.